So we're going to look at merging routes today. I'll just do a quick recap on this project. Rust in Axum, I'm going to be adding PostgreSQL and ultimately deploy it to Shuttle. I'm using Axum 0.7, which is still fairly new. I'm going to be writing a boilerplate repo that I can use and reuse with cargo generate. Going to learn a lot of concepts that I skipped over on previous projects. I just wanted to get it working and I didn't actually take the time to fully kind of understand. We're going to deploy this to Shuttle at the end and then we'll look at the differences and the benefits. That won't be in this video, but it will be at the end of this series. So far, I've added static files. We've connected to the Postgres database that is running in a Docker container. I've added app state, which works, but sometimes you have to be honest with yourself. I'm putting off connecting it all up and passing it around. We'll get to that in probably the next video. And yeah, please thumbs up and subscribe if you like these videos. So let's look at the routes, because that's where I'm adding most of the logic at the moment. And I've had to refactor slightly because when I first started the project, the routes were actually in main, and really don't want to be doing that because it will just get too big and difficult to manage. So yeah, as usual, got all the Axum imports, the usual ones. I've added extract state, which I've not used yet, but I will do, or intend to. We've got status code, JSON, response, extension, router, and so on. Cert AD serialize, create app state, which that will, yeah. That's the app state struct that I created in the previous video. You can see when I run the code that it's actually it's taking notice of the current state of the database connection. We've got first handler. So yeah, let's concentrate on the handlers. So the first handler just shows API works in H1 tags. That's just static HTML. The second handler, so that'll be a JSON message which gets printed to the screen or gets returned. The third handler is a bit more interesting because now I thought I'd ramp it up. So it will be taking a post request, and the request will be a name, and the name will just be a string. The response will be a greeting which will include the name that was passed in. And I've just added some random key value pair at the end just to illustrate that the response can be a totally different format. The response struct can be a totally different format to the request struct. You see, we had request data, response data. And so in many examples, you'll see that's the same. And that's a bit confusing, really, because you typically would want to be doing something to the request and then modifying it and appending to it and doing stuff and then putting it back into a response struct, which typically will have different and extra fields. I say extra because sometimes if you're using a database, you might actually pass in. Which way around is it? The database would assign an index, so you wouldn't pass that in with the request, but you would get it back from the response. Oh, that makes sense. So this is the handler for the JSON. You take in the request and you return the response. That's kind of, that there is JSON response there on, was that on line 60? If we go up to the top, you see, I did use Axum response JSON as JSON response. If you come from Python, that'd probably be quite familiar, where you do import pandas as PD or import NumPy as NP. You're making basically your own little alias. So when this code runs, it takes your request data, formats it, and then that's the first key value pair, and then the second key value pair is just stays as it is. So now here we go. We've got the route composition. So The router new now has three routes. First, handler one is get, handler two is get, handler three is post. This then it makes its way through to main. I'll show you that in a second. Sorry. Okay. And there we've got merge somewhere. We'll look at merge in a second. So yeah, merge. So that's different. If you get to my GitHub repo, you can look at the diffs for the between each branch, and you'll see the diffs, and you'll see that previously I had two routes there. I think I had route hello one and hello two, something like that. Now it's merging the routes, and the routes.comp is that router new that you saw in the routes.rs. And then nest service. Nest service is serving the static files. And that's the app state, which I've yet to use because I'm putting it off because I think it might be difficult. Right, let's do cargo run. You see the app state is happening. The state is being captured. Let's come up here. And let's do, I've still got in my history, the curl command to check it. So I'm not going to lie, these curl commands are just boring to compose, I would say. So just chat GPT it. There you go. So I just passed it the root handler code, and then it just produced me the curl command. So to be honest, once you've done it a few times, you get the hang of it. But yeah. Couldn't even be bothered to type that. So yeah, that's the response. So we've got greeting, hello John, and then Bitcoin 21. So that was kind of pre already in the code. That would be well, that'd be a string literal. I don't know if that gets stored on the stack or not. Well, it's in a struct. Don't know. Perhaps someone can tell me, would that 21 be stored on the stack? But it's inside a struct, so I think it will still get stored inside on the stack. String literal would be stored on the, not on the heap. It'd be stored below the heap. Hello, John. That's passed in as a it's a string, so that would be on the heap. So not that it really matters, but it's just nice to consider these things. So yeah, that's just the update. If I quickly just show GitHub, yeah, just check the diffs if you're interested in what I've changed. So I had the handler one, handler. I've added handler one, handler two, and handler three now. So yeah, when you look at that, you'll see hello one, hello two, hello three, and I've got rid of just hello. So the merge. This is where you can go now if you don't like looking at source code. So the merge, what it's doing is it's taking more than one route and then it's merging them. So presumably R is a generic type, and it goes into router where the type S. I don't know what generic type S is. I'm not very good with generics yet. They still puzzle me when you see a generic. I know that's a generic, but I don't. That's probably string, is it? I don't know. But yeah, generics with these capitals, and you never quite know what they represent. Well, I don't yet. I guess it's just familiarity. So yeah, merge. This is the source code for merge. Merge, comes under the router methods merge there. Like, this is a bit more user friendly there. So you can see what's happening there. You can use merge. You can chain merge together with what they did there was user routes and team routes, but you can just merge everything. Merge with fallbacks. If two routers that each have a fallback are merged, this is because router only allows a single fallback. Okay. I prefer just one merge. But there we go. So that's merge, which I've used with the root composition. So that's basically combining three roots into a router, and then you pass the router through into main, and then with main, which is your app, you then merge that. So yeah, thanks for watching. I'll be back soon.